गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। सो हियर वी आर सपोज टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेथड ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स बाय डिस्कवरी मेथड। देन आल्सो वी आर सपोज टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टीचिंग फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ प्रूफ, बिकॉज वी नो दैट इन द मैथमेटिक्स प्रूविंग मैथमेटिकल statement, that is a proposition, is one of the activity, because by doing that we understand how that mathematical proposition has come, how that mathematical proposition are derived and how it works. And we also have a feeling that we are not using as it is given in the textbook or it is taught by the teacher, but it is true in the sense also. Otherwise, when we will not show that how it is working, how the mathematical statement can be proved, a student may feel difficulty in understanding the mathematical propositions, because without the understanding that how it works, they are supposed to learn that. So that's all. That's why we have a proving of mathematical statement mathematics. So that also we will see some of the part of the proof, that how we are proving in mathematics, is already discussed in the unit 1, like that the direct proof, indirect proof, and within the indirect proof, proof by contradiction, proof by contrapositive, and proof by disproof or a counter example, that we have already seen there. So that we will not discuss. However, some of the part of induction and deduction also we have seen previously, that is the inductive reasoning and deductive reasoning. Here we will use those reasoning to see that by using those reasoning how we can prove the mathematical statement. Okay, so that is we will be doing. Then we will see that how the induction and deduction are interrelated to each other and what are the basic difference between that. We will also see about the problem solving, some of the things we have seen previously also, but here we will see that in a little bit detailed form. And also we will see the different approaches of teaching mathematics, like the 5B model, icon model, collaborative strategy, peer learning, self learning kind of a thing. As I remember, these things we have also discussed during the physical science pedagogy in the last year. So you will also find it easy to understand this type of a thing when we will be discussing. So today with this class we will start with the learning by discovery, or what is the discovery method, how we use the discovery method in teaching learning of mathematics. Discovery learning is also known as a heuristic method. Okay, so when we talk about the heuristic method or a discovery method, actually it is a method where the student, they discover the logic or the process of solving the problem or properties of different mathematical equations or mathematical geometrical structure, geometrical objects by themselves. It is not like that the teacher will come in the class and they will be orienting about them, and they will the student will be passive listener, or they will be other kind of activity. Here actually problem is either supplied by the teacher, or the students are themselves encouraged to identify the problem. Okay, and then identifying the problem, they will search for the reason, search for the you can say the way that how that problem can be solved. So it is basically based upon the discovery, means the student, the learner will discover the way of solving the problem. And that's why the heuristic method is also known as a discovery method. And here the independent discovery of the learner is emphasized, and that's why the learner here is also termed as a discoverer, means who are responsible for discovering the way to solve the problem, and or the inventor. And that's why you can, I think, easily can find out that since the students are encouraged to discover, students are encouraged to identify that how you can solve the problem, or what could be the method of solving the problem, what are the ways of solving the problem. So if they will be encouraged for that, so obviously it will foster, it will develop the sense of inquiry, sense of scientific temper, sense of working with a logical approach, and it will also develop the creativity and a critical thinking among the learner, because here the learner itself are the responsible for finding the way, means how that the problem can be solved. So in that sense it develops the creativity and a critical thinking also. It develops the attitude of a discoverer, means whenever they will find a problem, they won't search that how it will be solved with the teacher or a parents or a elder or a colleagues, rather than not a colleague, it's a peer member, rather than they will think by themselves. Okay, and when we see the epistemological epistemology of the discovery method or a heuristic method, it is basically derived from a Greek word that is the heurisko, that is the literary meaning is that I find. Okay, means I find means that I will identify the problem, or the problem will be supplied by the teacher, and then I will try to chalk out that how this can be solved, and I will get it. So that is the main reason of assigning the heuristic method, that is derived from the Greek word heurisko. Okay, and obviously here the student will do everything, and the teacher will be acting as a facilitator, as we know in the constructivist paradigm, and that's why it is the constructivist method of teaching. Here teacher is not supposed to tell them how the problem will be solved, how the mathematical problem will be addressed, rather than they will supply some of the information for supporting them, for encouraging them. Okay, so that is the main motto of the heuristic method. When we see that how it has been developed, how it has been originated, so one of the thing that we had already seen just now, that the name heuristic method, okay, it is given by the given from the Greek word heurisko. Okay, but who have developed this, means who is responsible, who is a contributor in developing the heuristic or a discovery method as the methods of teaching? So the first name comes, that the Henry Edward Armstrong, that is the H.E. Armstrong. He was a British chemist in the London, and he was a chemist, but he had a positive attitude, and he have an interest in the teaching learning of our children. And when he used to interact with them, he found out that the label of teaching science and mathematics, this kind of a thing, is very unsatisfactory. It is a very vague. The way it is taught in the classroom, the science and mathematics, that is not actually the appropriate way of teaching science and mathematics. And that's why he was a very unsatisfied and disappointed. he was also in the opinion that science and mathematics is not a subject that can be taught or learned through the textbook. Science and mathematics we cannot learn, and it cannot be also taught through the mathematics. Rather than the student themselves as an independent learner will gather the information and arrange it logically to come up with a solution or to develop, generate, create the concepts related to mathematics and science. So he was in that opinion, and that's why he has framed a way of teaching where the student will be given the optimal responsibility. They will be given a freedom to identify a problem or let it be supplied by the teacher also, but they will be working on how to solve the problem, and obviously the teacher will be helping them that in the way of solving the problem. So the Professor Henry Edward Armstrong is supposed to be the originator, father of the heuristic method or a discovery method. Okay, sometime when you will be attending for the CTET or state OTET examination, this is also used to be asked that who is responsible, who have originated the discovery method or a heuristic method of teaching. So that is the Henry Edward Armstrong. Then as I have told that the basic of the heuristic method is that to develop a student as a independent thinker, independent discoverer, independent inventor. Okay, so here actually how it happens, because the students are given opportunity to think, given opportunity to collect the artifacts, given opportunity to collect the logic in which it will be arranged so that to come up with a solution. So the child position is a developer or a thinker, not a problem that is a passive listener or a passive learner, and that role of a teacher is also a facilitator rather than the supplying the information and teaching the step by step to solve a problem. So this is the very unique feature of this method, which is also in line with the constructivist paradigm, because in the constructivist paradigm also the student is supposed to have a optimal maximum freedom to discover, to work, to experiment, to observe, to manipulate, to learn the things, rather than to be a passive listener. Okay, so that is the very unique feature of this. Even this discovery method aims at training the learner in the methods of learning, and that's why it develops the self-confidence and obviously the originality. Because suppose that you have come across a problem, or I have supplied a problem to you, mathematical problem, and I have also supplied that how to solve that problem. So you will be knowing only the one way of solving the problem. Your self-confidence may not develop, but when I will leave up to you, so you will think, you will also judge that suppose that I have found out 10 method of solving a single problem. So out of the 10 method, which method is easy, which method is less time consuming, with which method may go for the less mistake, because if the method involves lots of calculations, so the chances of committing mistake will be more. But if the method involves less calculation, scope for calculation, then the chances of committing mistake will be less. And if they will judge, they will devise lots of methods of teaching, then obviously it will develop the originality. It will come the originality, means their original thinking will come. So, and obviously if they are able to solve with a variety of a method, if their originality is coming, so in turn it will develop a self-confidence, which may not be possible in other way of teaching mathematics. But in this method, it is quite possible to develop the confidence, originality, power of a thinking and independent judgment. Okay. So obviously if the self-confidence will be there, so students will be successful in the future. And that's why when we talk about the Rebur WM, he is also in opinion that heuristic method is a method where the people discovers a thing by themselves. People put the position of a pioneer and they find their way along with the path of a knowledge, as did those who first discover the fact, and a principle and law which are known all which are now known to all. Means when they will discover, when they will find out the way to do, way to handle, way to solve a problem by themselves, it will develop a kind of a joyful feeling, and they will become a discoverer. And it will also give them a feeling that how the person who have discovered that for the first time, like that when we talk about the Euclidean geometry. So the concept of a Euclidean geometry, who have that is developed by the Euclid, so how they have developed, they will have a feeling of that, and that will motivate the learner to learn in the better manner. Okay. And that's why in the same fashion, the Westway also says that heuristic method is intended to provide training in method, and the knowledge is a secondary consideration altogether. Means here the primary thing is that how to learn, how to knowledge to be generated. The knowledge that we generate is a secondary, but here we learn how the things work. Okay. So that is the most important part in the heuristic method. So shall we have a very small question answer session, that whatever the question or whatever the doubt you have till now, you will ask here. Yes, any question if you have till now?
Sir, the Rybers of the last line,
last line aap nahi bujhe,
last line
kiska, last line is that the people is put in the position of a pioneer, and they find their way along the path of a knowledge, as did those who first discovered the fact, principle and a law which are now known to all. I have already told that they will have a feeling, that what kind of a feeling the person had when they have discovered the same concept for the first time. Because now whatever we are studying at a school level, it is not discovered by us, it is discovered by someone else, by the different mathematician, scientist and the different person. We used to study their developed theories and concepts. So when the student will be guided to discover, to find out those things by themselves, then they will have that kind of a good feeling, and that will motivate them. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay to you? Any other?
Sir, is there any difference between heuristic and discovery?
No. I have told you that, see, I have written in oblique. Hana, heuristic method, oblique, the discovery method. Both are same method.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that's how I see now. See the slide in the top part heading, I have written the oblique discovery oblique the heuristic method. Both are same. Apart from that, so shall we proceed towards the next thing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when we find the procedures that should be adopted in the heuristic method, here there are 3 step is suggested when we think about, when we think of planning for the heuristic method, because if we are trying to have a heuristic method or a discovery method as an approach for teaching mathematics, so this involves 3 different phases. Okay, the first phase is the planning phase, then the execution, and then the conclusion. So in the planning phase, so there is a spelling mistake, it is not a deterring, it is a determining. Okay, so when we think about the planning phase, we have to first determine the aims, then formulate the objective. Means through the teaching, what kind of a aim you are fixing, what kind of a objective you have formulated. Because we know that whenever we plan for the teaching and learning, okay, whenever we plan teaching and learning, we have to consider the several things. One thing is that the topic, the concept you are going to teach, then the sub concepts and main concept within the topic you are going to teach. Then you have to determine that who are your audience, what are their socioeconomic background, what are their achievement level. Then you have to determine that what are the objective, aim and objective you have out of your teaching, because as when you are going to the class, before going to the class, you must have an objective that out of my teaching, 1 hour or a 45 minute or a 30 minute, I want to achieve these things. Okay, so then we plan for the assessment strategy, that what are the assessment strategy that you have planned, that how you will assess the learning, and then the teaching aids, like kind of a thing. And obviously when we talk about all those things, it is not a separate to each other. Means first you have to fix the concept, then you have to identify the sub concept and a main concept, then you have to identify the objective, then the teaching method, then you have to think about the learner, then you have to think about the teaching aids. It is not like that. Each are interrelated to each other. Means whatever the objective I will fix, that will be dependent on the learner also, that will be dependent on the content also, that will be independent on the methods of teaching also, and the learning aids also, and the assessment criteria also. Similarly, whenever we will fix the assessment criteria, it will also be decided based on the objective, teaching method, and like that others. So all the things are interrelated to each other, it is not a separate from each other. Okay, so but here the main thing is that whatever the topic is there and whoever the student is there, you have to decide whether it is feasible. Feasibility I am talking, I am not talking that it cannot be adapted. Sometimes the student says that it is not possible to adapt a heuristic method or a discovery method in school mathematics. I do agree, for the some of the content is, it is difficult, but for the when we talk about the school mathematics, it is quite possible for all the topic. It becomes difficult later on in the higher stage. okay, like that the plus two level or like that the graduation level, it becomes complex. But whatever the content we have up to the high school level, it is quite possible. Okay, it is quite possible. And so that's why you have to decide that what content you are going to teach, what are your objective is there, and while the objective you are framing, is it possible to have a discovery method, or do you feel competent enough in organizing discovery method for that particular topic? Because if you find, then you have to formulate the objective and you have to fix your aim accordingly. If you don't, then you have to little bit divert from the objectives and aim. Then you have to select the specific problem, that within that concept, what are the specific thing that you will be teaching. And you have to also be prepared with the tentative solution of the problem, because sometimes student may find it difficult to identify, to frame the solution based on their self. So you have to identify, you have to keep ready at least one tentative solution. It will be better if you are having a more than one tentative solution of the problem. Then at a next phase, you have to execute that whatever you have planned in the first phase. Here, while the executing, you have to assign the problem to the student, or you have to encourage the student to identify a problem, and then you have to observe or discover or investigate. You have to encourage the student to investigate, discover or observe in the search of a solution. You have to encourage, you have to, you may be required to provide some guidelines also, some of the steps also, so that they will find it easy. Otherwise, if you will give that, okay, so do it by yourself, so it, student may find it difficult and they may be demotivated. So that's why they must be supplied some guidance, and that's why they feel it easy in order to identify, investigate, discover and observe in the search of the solution. And then you have to help them in inferring and interpreting the observation. Suppose that in order to solve any problem, they have observed something, they have collected some data, they have experimented something, they have manipulated something. So you have to help with the guidelines, then how to out of those observation, how to out of those manipulation and experimentation, you have to come up with the interpretations, how you have to interpret and how you have to infer. Then after they will come the inference, you have to help them in the conclusion, how to draw a conclusion and generalize. Suppose that for sake of example, you have given a task like that, to find out that what will be the sum of all interior angle of a polygon. So they will measure lot of a triangle and they will find that it is a 180 degree. They will measure the internal angle of a lot of quadrilaterals and they will find it is a 360 degree, like that. So they will measure the pentagon, hexagon, septagon, octagon, like that, and they will come up with some numbers, and then you have to help them in generalizing the observation they had, generalize and come at the solution, that is a new knowledge. So here they were measuring the sum of internal angle of a polygon. So what is the sum of internal angle of a polygon? Can anybody say? Do you know? Anybody? Nobody of you know that what is the sum of internal angle? Formula for sum
sir, n minus n minus 2 into 180.
Sir,
n minus
yes, yes,
2
yes.
into 180.
Okay, okay. Bibhu, it is not 360 degree. Polygon I am talking. So, yes, correct answer is that n minus 2.
Yes.
Haan, n minus 2. N minus 2 multiplied by 180 degree. Somewhere it is also written 2n minus 4 multiplied 90. By right angle. Assembly. Right angle 90 degree, the same thing. So there are the different variation of the same formula. So that is a generalized out of the observation. Okay. So these are the basically three process in the adapting a discovery method. Here it is the same thing that I have written, so it is not required to discuss. Now they are the same thing, whatever I have explained it was the same thing. Now we will see the what is the role of teaching through mathematic discovery method. What is the role of a teacher when they try to teach through the discovery method or a heuristic method? But before that we will have a small question answer session related to the method of teaching, that is the steps of teaching mathematics with the discovery or a heuristic method. Do you have any question related to that the step that we have talked now? Do you have any doubt? No doubt.
No, sir. Observing method same
like okay. So.
Sir, yeah. Heuristic method to problem solving method वाले लागू.
Hello.
Heuristic method to problem solving method वाले लागू.
I am not able to understand your point. Can you type in the chat box? I think most of the time when you talk, you keep the mouthpiece very near to the phone. That's why always I find it difficult. Keep the mouthpiece a little bit apart from your mouth so that the voice will come clear. Can you send your queries in the chat box? Please send in the chat box. I will see and respond it. Okay, Asutosh.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Are you? Ha. Chat me bhej dijiye. I will respond it. So meanwhile, he is typing. We will see the role of teacher in the teaching through the discovery method. Okay. How many time I will tell you, Asutosh? And the same question was asked earlier also by somebody. So it is a sufficient evidence that you are not listening carefully whatever I am talking. The same question comes. I have talked about this, so I will not respond. You consult your peer members also. Okay, that will be a peer learning. Okay, Asutosh. If it is a different question, sure, I have responded. So when we see the responsibility or a role of a teacher when they have planned for teaching mathematics with this method. Okay. So here the role of a teacher is a facilitator, not as a supplier of the information or to supply the different aspect of the content that they are going to teach or the problem which is in hand. So here the main role of a teacher is the facilitator of a knowledge. They are supposed to facilitate the learner in the process of learning and discovering the solution of a problem in a hand. And that's why because here you have to work, teacher has to work as a facilitator. So that's why the teacher must be very resourceful, and they must have a spirit in themselves. Okay, because a variety of a teacher will student will be there, varieties of problem will be arising, and variety of requirement of a student will be there. So it is supposed to be a very resourceful teacher. So those who are very well versed in the different aspect of the content that they have planned to teach by the discovery method, and they may have they must have a self spirit, self motivation for that. Unless or until the teacher is having motivation for engaging the learner in this method, it will be quite difficult to engage the learner with this method. Okay, so that is the one of thing. Then the relationship between the teacher and the student should be very cordial relationship. The type of a question that is chosen, that should be well planned. It is not like that the random you will choose the question, and when you will engage the learner in the learning situation, either the learner will find it difficult to explore the solution of a problem, or the teacher will find it difficult to come up with the appropriate solution and the suggest the learner for finding the solution. So that the question must be very careful chosen, and it is they must have a very cordial relationship, and they must provide the different guidelines so that it will be easy and motivating while the student will be searching for the solution of a problem. And the teacher should be also a very conscious, very sincere, patience and alert. Patience because here the student may take more time than the usual. You must be sincere, and you must be very vigilant and observer, good observer, so that you can observe that how and why the students are doing, and what kind of mistakes they are committing, so that you can provide a supplementary steps at appropriate moment, so that the student will go in the right direction for solving the problem. Then also that teacher should help the student in identifying a situation, a suitable problem. Here the teacher role is not only to supply a problem, but also they should be encouraged to identify the problem by themselves. Means the student must be encouraged. Okay, so you must be very planned in providing a situation to identify the problem, and here you have to think about their mind, means the development level, achievement level, age group, the socio-economic condition, and the level of a learner like that, and the facilities available also. Sometimes you may think of providing something, but the appropriate facilities are not available. Sometimes it is also like that overdoing of this method, any method, it is not like especially for this method. Overdoing any method creates a monotonous situation. So the monotonous situation kind of a thing should not happen in the classroom. Rather than the teacher must use the variety of a method, and at a frequent level, at a periodic level, they can use the discovery method also. And they should not use the discovery method for the very obvious kind of a thing, so that children will find that it is a very obvious what it needs to be done. So it should be a little bit challenging for them. Okay, and obviously, as I have talked you, that detailed instruction sheet is a must to be provided to the student, otherwise they will find it a very difficult. The different supplementing supplementary resources also should be arranged by the teacher, by the library or by the other means, so that the learner can go there and they can enrich the way they are exploring about the solution of a problem, so that providing an appropriate supplementary problem is very much essential here also. Next thing is that as here the students are discovering, they are finding out the solution by themselves, so there may be required to respond a lot of question, lot of a question may be generated in the student's mind. So teacher must be very cool and calm and patienceful to respond the question and encourage the learner to ask the question also, because asking a question, asking for a help is one of the important aspect here, because the learner is finding the solution by themselves. And the most important part in the discovery method is that teacher must provide a very open and a free atmosphere for the learner, where they will be encouraged for the self development and the self expression. So the this is the very important aspect of the from the part of a teacher when you are planning for discovery method. Okay, so we will stop this class up to here only, and now we will have a question answer session regarding the whole thing that we have discussed today. So whatever the question you have, you may ask now, question, queries or anything. Any queries? Okay. So Ashutosh, you just explore by yourself that whether problem solving method and discovery method are equal or not equal. ठीक है, you may see your syllabus also, you will find it. So so in the coming days it will be cleared when I will talk other aspect of the methods also. Okay, so if there is no question, so shall we stop this class here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you,
so,
sir.
So thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you.